What's up everyone? We're back with another tutorial in Cubase. Today I'm going to show you all how to use the manual. Now if you already use the manual, you'll say this is dumb, but a lot of people don't use the manual and I was one of those people. What I used to do, my typical process was if I ran into a problem, I would Google it. Then I would check the Steinberg and Cubase forums because Google would always lead me there, and if that didn't work, I would search the forums to try to find the specific answer. If that didn't work, I would search YouTube so I could see someone demonstrating it. And if that didn't work, I would go back to the forums and ask a question. And a lot of times when I asked a question, people would say, it's in the manual. Now, when someone says it's in the manual, they're not being a dick because it probably is in the manual. And what they're trying to do is turn you onto a fantastic resource that can solve a lot of your problems. You can find all sorts of useful information in there and it's not that hard to use. So let's get to it and show you how I use the manual. When you're working in Cubase and you run into a problem, you just hit F1 and the manual comes up. And as you can see, it's 1,344 pages of information about how to use Cubase. And Steinberg is a German company, and I don't know if this is prejudiced to say, but the Germans are really good at writing software documentation. So let's say back here in Cubase we have this Q, which is quantize, and IQ, which is iterative quantize. And I want to find out about what is this iterative quantize all about. So I come back to my manual. I can pull it up by hitting F1. And there it comes. I hit Control F or Command F if I'm on a Mac, and I type in iterative. So iterative, I get several results, 17 it looks like. IQ mode applies a loose quantization so that your audio or MIDI moves only part of the way to the closest quantize grid. That seems like it might be useful. Like let's say I did a piano passage that was a bit sloppy and I wanted to clean it up, but I didn't want to be stiffer than an 18-year-old getting his first lap dance. Iterative quantize might be a good thing to use. Now let's say, what is the deal with all these compressors in Cubase and what do they do? I could just search compressor and I get a ton of results, but we can just go through here. Compressor here, the standard compressor, smooth compression effects, the tube compressor, versatile compressor with tube simulation, smooth and warm compressor effects, vintage compressor, modeled after vintage type compressors, and each one has all of the parameters you would need to use. So if you're looking for information about Cubase or answering your questions, a lot of times the manual is a good first resort. And then if that doesn't work, you can start Googling it and going to the Steinberg forums and looking on YouTube. So I hope you found this video helpful, because the manual is a good place to start when you're looking for information on Cubase, and this is the way that I use it. You may use it in a different way, but I just wanted to turn you all on to a fantastic resource for learning how to do things, and I hope that I did. So have a great day, everyone. Bye.